and her betrayer.
Very well.
Ah!
stop. You will go no further. You do not have the right to demand my name. You have defiled our temple. No more. You will tell me now, intruder, why you have done all this. Why have you come here? You did this all for an ancient relic. Know this, stranger. The prophet Andraste has overcome death itself and has returned to her faithful in a form more radiant than you can imagine. Not even the Tevinter Imperium could hope to slay her now. What hope do you have? None but the disciples may approach Andraste. But perhaps there is a way to make up for your recent... It may be because I believe in second chances. Perhaps through Andraste's mercy, her greatest enemy will become her greatest champion. You dare to threaten the holy and beloved Andraste! To arms, my brethren!
Enemies approaching!
A foe worthy of the great Ogryn. Wait till the boys and tapsters hear about this.
has begun. Very well.
Do you feel that? Place is practically in view.
I bid you welcome, Pilgrim. You have come to honor Andraste, and you shall, if you prove yourself worthy. Still, it is not my... If you are found worthy, you will see the urn and be allowed to take a small pinch of the ashes for yourself. No. Before you go, there is something I must ask. There is suffering in your past. You rose above your caste to become a Grey Warden, but you left behind your family, who relied on you. Tell me, Pilgrim, did you fail them? Then you do not dwell on past mistakes.
It's easy for others to judge what you've done in hindsight, but it doesn't make it any better.
It is sometimes difficult to see how our actions affect an outcome, but that does not mean our actions had no effect.
I don't really know about these guardian types, but I think the correct answer was yes.
And what of those that follow you? Alistair, Knight, and Warden. You wonder if things would have been different if you were with Duncan on the battlefield. You could have shielded him from the killing blow. You wonder, don't you, if you should have died and not him?
Yes. If Duncan had been saved and not me, everything would be better. If I just had the chance, maybe I...
Ask your question, Guardian. I am ready.
You are ever the advisor, ready with a word of wisdom. Do you wonder if you spout only platitudes, burned into your mind in the distant past? Perhaps you are only a tool, used to spread the word of the Circle and the Chantry. Does doubt ever chip away at your truths?
You frame the statement in the form of a question. Yet you already know our answers. There is no sense in hiding, is there? Yes, I do doubt at times.
Ah, the dwarf. The way is open. Good luck.
Echoes from a of what do I speak? Echoes from a shell of what do I speak? A dream came upon me as my daughter slumbered beneath my heart. It told of her life and of her betrayal and death. I am sorrow and regret.
The smallest love of what do I speak? Yes. I was Andraste's dearest friend in childhood, and always we would sing. They say the Maker himself was moved by Andraste's song.
An eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. The debt of blood must be paid in full. Of what do I speak? Yes, my husband Hisarion would have chosen a quick death for Andraste. I made him swear that she would die publicly with her war leaders, that all would know the Imperium's strength. I am justice. I am vengeance.
I'd neither a guest nor a trespasser be. In this place I belong, that belongs also to me. Of what do I speak? I'd neither a guest nor a trespasser. Of what do I speak? I'd neither a guest nor a trespasser be. Of what do I speak? That is not of what I speak.
Shall be done.
A poison of the soul, passion's cruel counterpart. From love she grows, till love lies slain. Of what do I speak? A poison of what do I speak? Yes, jealousy drove me to betrayal. I loved her too.
The bones of the world stretched towards the sky's embrace. Of what do I speak? Yes, no more.
No man has seen it, but all men know it. Lighter than air, sharper than any sword. Comes from nothing, but will fell the strongest armies. Of what do I speak? No. Of what do I speak? Yes, hunger was the weapon used against the wicked men of the Tiventer Imperium. The Maker kindled the sun's flame, scorching the land. I am Kefir, disciple of Andraste and commander of her armies.
She wields the broken sword and separates true kings from tyrants. Of what do I speak? That is...
Careful! I think they've seen us!
Hey, what's shaping? That's all you have to say? Not even a sorry I ran you through. There's friendship for you, I guess. So am I, Selraka. I had to do what I did to survive, and so did you. I don't blame you for leaving us all.
That's the way it goes, isn't it? You can't afford to think about the past. You have to look forward. I'm proud of you for moving on. Here, I found this lying around and I've no use for it. I know you'll do something good with it. Goodbye, my friend. Remember me.
There's only one way forward.
Hey, you see those thingies over on the side of that huge chasm? I bet they're used for... I don't think it's solid enough to stand on, but it's a start. What? That's it! That's an actual bridge piece right there. If we can get all the bridge pieces to be solid, we can make it across. Let's go.
Your wish.
Thank you. Andraste only favored the clever, it seems.
Been through the trials of the Gauntlet. You have walked the path of Andraste, and like her, you have been cleansed. You have proven yourself worthy, Pilgrim. Approach the Sacred Ashes.
Succeed in finding Andraste's final resting place. But here she is.
I could not have asked for a greater honor than to be here. I will never forget this feeling.
That's it? Thought it would be bigger.